Things are never quite what they seem. We only see the front, without paying attention to the shadows hiding behind it. All the world is a stage. And all the men and women, merely actors in the tragedy that is life. Recently, mysteries that seem so far away from me are getting closer and are starting to show themselves in the light of truth. My name is Rose Hawkins. I'm an inspector of the Juvenile Division of Massachusetts. For several weeks, I investigated the case of a missing girl named Eden. All of this led me to an old and abandoned asylum in the north of the country. But details are blurring out. My recent memories faded away, as if it was hiding behind a cold and wet fog. When I opened my eyes, all I can remember is a man pointing a gun at me and shooting me down. Still alive. How is it possible? I'm still bleeding. I need to find something to heal myself.
If you are listening to this message, it means you finally woke up. You've probably noticed, but it's impossible for us to speak in this place. I can't speak to you, and you can't speak to me. We can only think inside our own little minds. And that's why I use this old recorder to talk to you. I have a deal to propose, but you need to find me first. Hello, Rose. How are you today?
That was more than 10 years ago, and the asylum never opened its doors again.
Thank you.
You are probably wondering why such a lovely girl like you got into this dark and cold place. Well, my dear, I'm afraid it's your fault. We told you not to trust anyone. Oh, but you probably don't remember anyway. It's one of those side effects caused by the shock that affected your memory. I'm even willing to bet that you don't remember the last few hours. Why did you come to this asylum to investigate? Why did you come alone? What did you find? What happened? And who shot you? So many questions left unanswered.
Be my only chance to get out of this place. I really should find this nurse before she changes her mind. So I need to find a nurse and free her. What does that mean? I just found my nurse. What happened to her?
Doctor, I'm not here to confide my problems to you or some bullshit like that. I don't believe in those stories about working on oneself, subconscious, or neurosis. Just because I'm a nurse doesn't mean I can't see what you're scheming. The reason I came is because I'd like to know what happened to my six patients, Doctor. They didn't magically vanish. What have you done to them? Why were they crying every day after your sessions? Your little experiments on them failed, so you got rid of them? Is that it, Doctor? They were living proofs of your incompetence, and you couldn't stand it? Anyway, you'll understand that I can't close my eyes on such a matter, Doctor. Though money could help me look the other way.
Thank you.
Looks like an old surface elevator. I should check if it's still working. I wonder what kind of experiment they conducted here. She must have experienced a lot of pain. Sweetie, are you okay? What are you doing here? My name is Rose. What's your name? She's ignoring me. I need to find a way to open this gate. Don't worry. I'm going to get you out of here. Stay there, okay? Thank you.
Thank you.